Hi there, welcome to Mini-Math Lessons with Karen Greenhouse. So today I am going to be focusing on some elementary lessons or topics. And so I have created these lessons in Classpad.net, which is a free for students, teachers, parents, whoever wants to use it. And when you create an activity, it creates a URL that you can then just share. So I am going to type in the URL for the activity that I've created here, which is about, take just a minute for it to come up. So I have shared my URL on the video here below and also in the article that's the blog post that has these in this as well. So when you type in the URL, you're going to get this activity. So this is an activity to basically help students discover things about polygons. What is a polygon? How come they're named certain ways? What are vertices? What are sides? Those types of things. So as you can see, there's a place. This is using Classpad.net. Free software. If you like it and you want to keep the activity, you want to make sure you create an account so that you can save it. So I have some very simple questions here. I've told them what each shape is. I've given it its name and by color, so you'll see that here they are by color and by their name. And basically I've said, why don't you use your arrow tool and explore the polygon? So I've told them that these are polygons and that the points of the polygons are called vertices and that the straight segments are called sides. So now I want them just to explore. So what do they notice about the different polygons that are in this shape below? So when it says use the arrow tool and they click on this geometry sticky, there's an arrow and they're just going to then go up and start exploring what happens if I move these points. Well, this one is the pentagon, and if I move it, it has still 5 points, it still has 5 sides, so I want them to explore what happens. The shape is changing, but what's not changing? The number of points, the number of sides, those types of things. So the idea here is to just have students explore and make different shapes. So this is that quadrilateral, but now it looks like a square, something I'm familiar with. Wow, but if I moved it like this, it is no longer a square, now it's a kite or a boomerang, however you want to describe it. So the whole idea is for them to explore, write down what they're observing. What do they notice about the vertices? What do they notice about the sides? And hopefully the goal is, as they're exploring these different polygons, they're coming to this understanding that a polygon is this closed figure, right? And it has a certain number of points and it has a certain number of sides, and the points and the sides for each figure seem to match. So like 4 points, 4 sides, 5 points, 5 sides, 6 points, 6 sides, things like that. So these are the things we want them to try to hopefully figure out. And if you're working with the students and they don't notice everything, maybe you can ask them a good question. So this is a great thing to do together. So as I scroll down, there's some more explorations. Okay, so we've explored, now we think we know what a polygon is. So now, where do those names come from? How come the polygons have different names? So this is a triangle, this is a quadrilateral, this is a pentagon. So now we're giving them a little bit more information. Okay, so you've got your polygons, and here's what these names mean. Try. So how are these names related to the shapes themselves? So again, they're going to use their arrow tool and they're going to explore. So here's a triangle, that means three. Well, what does it have three of? Well, it has 3 points, it has 3 sides, it has 3 angles, if we're going to talk about angles, which does come up in these definitions as well. So again, we're trying to get them to understand what is a polygon and where do these names for polygons come from, and it is connected to the vertices and the sides and the angles, and that's what we're trying to get them to understand. And so they're going to write down their observations here in this text sticky. And finally, when we move down, is okay, now you think you have an understanding of this, why don't you try to construct your own polygons? And so I've given them 3. You could add more, you could challenge them if you're going to do this with your students. And it says use the polygon tool, so you'll notice when you click on it, there's this tool right here that is a polygon. And so they're just going to start and making their shape however they decide they're doing it. I don't know which one I'm making right now, but they're going to try to make these shapes. So this is just a very simple little exploration, little mini math lesson that helps students kind of get an understanding about what polygons are, what vertices are, what sides are, how come the names are the way they are. So a triangle has to do with the three sides, the three angles, the three points. So quick exploration. Feel free to use it. If you like it and you want to add to it, you can create an account in Classpad.net and save it. Up here, you'll see it says duplicate. So once you've created your own account, you can duplicate this activity and save it in your own account and modify and play with it as much as you want. And for teachers, if you want to use these activities with all of your students, all you need is the URL. And so let me move this down a little bit here. The URL here, each paper has a URL, and you simply can share that on your website, on your Google Doc, whatever, and all students can then access this paper and play around with it. So different ways to explore.